It's Friday again, and you know what date it is? It's the 31st of December, the final day of another year. And what an assembly to talk about is fish and chips. One of my most excitable moments this year was when I saw how to make an actual chip. I was like a child in a sweetie shop. So we're going to see that. But let's sing the great Christmas song called Noel, and you sing it out with all your heart.
Love incarnate, love divine, star and angels gave the sign. Bow to babe on bended knee, the savior of humanity. Unto us a child is born, he shall reign forever.
Quite emotional too, just covering the birth and life and death and resurrection of the lovely Lord Jesus. Let's go and find out the fish and the chips and the sausages. Oh, the thought of it. Here I go.
Boys and girls, guess where I am today? I'm absolutely starving. Look at my t-shirt, says do what you love. And one thing I love to do is eat food. And look what I've come across, a fish and chip shop. I love fish and chip. I love chips, I love fish, I love burgers and sausages. And you see, when you're hungry, I can eat absolutely anything. So we're going to go inside the fish and chip shop and order some food and see what we can learn about the fish and chip shop. Come on, show me the brothers. Smell that there. I love the smell of a chip shop. Look, taco chip, look at all these things you can eat. Gravy chips, taco chip, chip buddies, sausages, burgers. All I need to turn a table. Now what have I got? We've got pasties, I've got battered sausages. They look like burgers, but they're pasties. You can eat so much fish. Wow. And I thought, boys and girls, you see this here? We're in a fish and chip shop because it's local produce. It's very common on a weekend, especially for a Friday and a Saturday, for families to go out to the chip shop to buy their tea or their lunch. And I'm walking into the chip shop, one of the best moments of my life. You walk in the chip shop and somebody says, "What would you like to eat?" And I goes, "What's the limits?" "Whatever you want." And I goes, "What? Whew. Wee bit of everything, please, thank you." So I've got battered sausages, you've got sausages. Where do they come from? Do you know what animal sausages come from? Well, they come mainly from pigs, as does bacon. You got pigs, farmers here have got little baby piglets from birth to bacon, and then they're prepared into sausages and bacon. Then you've got burgers, mainly come from cattle. Where do the cattle come from? They come from Northern Ireland. Pigs, cattle, you get your burgers. Then of course you've got chicken. Where does a chicken come from? The chicken comes from the chicken. And Northern Ireland's got lots of chicken farmers, cattle farmers, pig farmers, and of course the chicken. Then you get your chicken burger, chicken fillets, chicken goujons, chicken nuggets. So you got chicken, you've got burgers, bacon, you've got pigs, chicken, cattle. And then of course you've got salads, local vegetable salads, homegrown. And the fish, where does that come from? Well, when you're sleeping, the fishermen are busy out fishing in their boats, on the rivers, on the sea, and they'll spend often all night, many hours, sometimes days, out in the ocean, out in the sea, and they're fishing for fish. And of course the fish is brought in and it's prepared early in the morning. The fishmonger brings the fish, then the chip owner, but long before the shop's open, they have to come to make preparation, prepare the fish, put the batter on it to make it tasty for you, ready for cooking. But I thought, whatever I think of all these animals, where do they come from? Well, look, in Northern Ireland, they come from Northern Ireland. We live in a very beautiful part of the world. They're very fertile, which means you've got lots of rain and sunshine making the grass green and plentiful. So the animals can enjoy the crops to make the meal for the pigs, for the chicken. The cattle can be outside grazing. And the fish, we live on an island here, so we can see the boats in Porta Ferry, Kilkeel Harbour. Boats are going continually in and out, bringing in the fish. But I thought, ultimately, where do the fish come from? Where do the animals come from? Where do the fruit, the vegetable come from? I think of the very beginning about God. And the Bible says, in the beginning, God created heaven and earth and everything in the earth. That's the animals. He created the fish, he created the pigs, the cattle, the chicken, all breeds of pigs, all breeds of cattle, all breeds of chicken, ultimately for our good and for our, the Bible says nothing is to be refused. So that's why animals are growing, for our pleasure, for our eating. It's important to eat, because if you don't eat, you'll die. But I'm also aware that in parts of the world, I've been to lots of parts of the world, and they don't have the food we enjoy. They don't have the weather to make the grass nice and green, therefore they just can't walk into a chip shop and have such a variety of food. Many of them just have a basic food like rice, and if it's a good day they might get chicken, they might get something else. But you walk into a chip shop, there's a whole range of food that you can really, really enjoy. That's number one lesson: be thankful in the country in which you were born, in which you will live. Go to the shops full of food, chip shops full of food, your cupboards full of food. Many parts of the world have no food in their shops, no food in their cupboards, and even no fish and chip shops to go to spend some money to buy food. But the Bible says, in everything give thanks. So whenever I come here and think of the sausages, the burgers, I have so much to choose from, so much to eat, therefore I want to be thankful. So Northern Ireland's a good country where you get lots of food and you can eat it, and I'm going to choose some food, I'm going to taste it, I'm going to eat it, and I'll even offer you some if you would like it. So that's a wee lesson, just to be thankful. And in Northern Ireland, whenever we think of the green grass, drive up the countryside, see all the cattle, all you can go to the pig farmer, see all the pigs, see all the chickens, see all the animals. And it makes us thankful we live in a country when you have lots and lots of food. But don't take that for granted. Sometimes we can go through life and be spoiled and take life all for granted, take food for granted, take God for granted, who gives us the sun and the rain and everything to enjoy. And do you know the sun, how far away it is? 93 million miles. Any closer, we would sizzle up like a sausage. Any further away, you'd freeze like an ice lolly. So he's placed it perfectly for our goodness to enjoy. And I love whenever the farmer sows the seed, you can't see nothing happening and suddenly you've got a field full of crops just for the animals. You go into a pig and you see a little baby pig, and before you know it's a big pig, little baby calf, before you know it's a big calf, and that's all the way it happens. Wonderful how they grow in such a short period of time. To make chips come from potatoes. Potatoes come from the farmer in the ground. So you have to get a, you don't get to buy a bag of chips, the farmer has to buy a bag of potatoes. Look, that's the potatoes you would just get in the farm, dirty, but in a moment it's going to be ready to eat. Wait till you see what happens. This is peeling the potatoes. Of course you need the hose, you need the water to wash them while it's been peeling. Wow. Look, less than a minute, the potatoes are almost peeled, they're washed, and you can only take a bite of them just as they are, but they need cooked. Wow. And they're not gonna be baby chickens, they're potatoes. Wow. So I've got myself a wee part-time job here. These are the potatoes, they've just been peeled. I just put them in here and start to peel them. Look at that chips. Wow, chips! Look at the chips! I never seen that leg up. Chips! Wow, that was so fast. Oh, I nearly eat whatever it is. There's something not right. That's not cooked. It looks like a chip, but it is cooked. Wow, all excited to get these chips. So now we've got the potatoes that have been washed or peeled, and now that's them ready to go straight into the oil. Really high temperature here. So here's the chips. They've all been cooked now, boiling hot oil, put in just ready for eat, and then of course it's sieved out, drained off. Big pot of oil. So when you come and order your chips, they put into whatever you want, a chip or two chips, they put into paper, wrapped up. Getting hungry by the second here. So here's the chicken. The chicken's been battered. You put flour on and it's battered, then it's cooked, then it's put there. So whenever you want a chicken, you can have it squashed or battered. It doesn't look like a hen or like a chicken. Of course, it's cut up and prepared. Here's put into the batter. You get the raw fish, it's put into the batter, turned over, it gets a good soaking of batter. Looks like custard to me, but it's batter. Then it's put into the piping hot oil to cook. And it just sits so you can see how hot the oil is. It's quite dangerous for children to be around here. Do you ever notice when you're cooking, your mum will say, stand back, or just wait, stand back, because you get too so close, you're gonna get burnt. But that's how it happens, very, very quickly. I think within minutes, that fish is gonna be cooked because the oil is so piping hot. And there's the finished product. Of course, you've got the chicken, it's battered, you've got pasties. I love pasty suppers. You get pasty and that's all different meats put together, and sausages and battered sausages. So this is what happens in the back of a chippy. It's all cooked, you come in, make your order, and it's prepared and wrapped up and given to you. Very exciting. Don't know what to eat, I'm gonna order some food. Any red sauce?
Yes.
So we've just got our fish and chip, and I'm so looking forward to eating it. Look at that fish, look at those chips. Mmm, wee bit of red sauce. Do you want a wee bite? Here, ha ha. Mmm, okay. Just at a chip shop, the long wait. I was so excited to see how they make the chips from the potatoes, how the animals walk in the field, and how you end up going through the process. And look what I've got, a lovely, lovely sausage. Do you want a wee bite? Mmm, oh, lovely. Oh, nom nom nom. Nom nom. Yes.
Thank you to that fish and chip shop in Belfast, the brothers Really, really enjoyed it, and we're going to sing about the Christmas tree and presents, and the best present right now for me would be a fish and chip. I would love the thought of it. Here we go. Here we go.
Let the Christmas tree remind you of the one who trusts the Lord, who walks the path of godliness and loves to hear God's word. Pray that as you grow up, that's just how you will be, standing over Jesus like a Christmas tree. Let your love show, let your faith grow, and everyone will know Christ will be our Christmas. Well, let the fairy lights remind you of that bright shining star, spotted by the wise men who traveled from afar. They gave Jesus all their treasures and they worshipped him that night. Let your worship of King Jesus shine like fairy lights. Let your love show, let your faith grow, that everyone will know Christ the King of Christmas. Remind you of God's amazing grace. Red the blood of Jesus as he suffered in our place. White the full forgiveness won as Jesus rose again. You can tell your friends the gospel with a candy cane. Let your love show, oh, oh, let your faith grow, oh, oh, oh. Let everyone will know Christ the King of Christmas. Gifts at Christmas time, fill your heart with praise to God for all his goodness shown in oh so many ways. That every day and every way will be completely his. Give your life to Jesus as a Christmas gift. Let your love show, oh, oh, oh. Let your faith grow, oh, oh, oh. That everyone will know. Let your love show, oh, oh. Let your faith grow, oh, oh, oh. That everyone will know.
What a lovely song to finish with, Christ the King of Christmas. We wish you a happy new year, and we're really, really looking forward to this year to reaching more and more children for the lovely Lord Jesus. Take care, bye.